Two men have been charged over the prison stabbing attack that's left Tony Mokbel fighting for life in hospital. Brett McLeod joins me now from the Royal Melbourne. Brett, what are the details?
It's two 21-year-old men, Peter, charged by the Armed Crime Squad with various charges, including intentionally causing serious injury, attempted murder, and causing serious injury intentionally in circumstances of gross violence. Both men are due to appear for a filing hearing in Geelong Magistrates Court on Friday. Meantime, Tony Mokbel, after that vicious attack yesterday, underwent surgery here at the Royal Melbourne last night, and he remains in a critical condition.
As associates of Tony Mokbel waited for news on his health, his fellow inmates at Barwon spent today in their cells.
That's why we will remain in lockdown until we understand who else is connected, who else may be at risk, and if there's any reprisal attacks that are likely to occur.
CCTV has given a clearer picture of yesterday's attack. Tony Mokbel was walking in the exercise yard back to his unit. It was 20 minutes before the regular lockdown. Two prisoners, described as Pacific Islander, allegedly assaulted him. Both were armed with a shiv or homemade knife. Staff would later find three weapons at the scene. Mokbel was stabbed in the face and chest. A 31-year-old inmate was also injured after coming to Mokbel's aid. Mokbel's former stepdaughter, Brittany Maguire, telling Nine News, "My dad is strong, he'll be fine. It will take more than this to bring him down." Coming after Carl Williams was bashed to death in the same prison, should this gangland figure have been in higher security?
Tony Mokbel has been housed safely in the mainstream compound at Bowen for a number of years without issue.
How often is that reviewed, that sort of security situation?
Regular.
The Premier says an independent investigation has begun.
It doesn't matter what we might feel about a particular person, we want our prisons to operate properly, and that means they need to be safe for everybody involved, particularly staff, and that's why this matter will be thoroughly investigated.
One theory as to why Mokbel was attacked: anger after a newspaper article said he disrupted a standover gang inside the prison. The state government says there's no indication Mokbel was targeted over his involvement in the Lawyer X scandal.
I certainly have no advice that that matter is relevant to what occurred yesterday. Let's wait and see the facts established.
But Mokbel's boasts that the police informer scandal would lead him to being freed didn't win him any friends inside.
He was very confident he would get out of jail.
Was that irritating other prisoners?
Oh, I suspect it probably was.
Meantime, in yet another chapter in the Lawyer X saga, underworld figure Mick Gatto has released a statement denying he threatened to kill her. Mr. Gatto was never a client of informer 3838. Not only is the reporting false, it's mischievous and damaging to Mr. Gatto. More may come to light when the Lawyer X Royal Commission begins on Friday. Brett McLeod, Nine News.